and welcome to another edition of Skate Shop Stories. Okay, this edition is going to be quite a big catch-up because there have been a few weeks that I've definitely missed, and my intention at the start of the year was to record a weekly episode for myself, and so that people would just know the kind of amazing people that we get in our shop. Because I love this space. I feel energized when I come in here in the morning, and I feel just cozy and safe most of the day. And I really hope that people who visit this space feel the same way. But something happened to me in February, and it kind of took the whole of February, and it took my focus off the positive and skewed it very much onto the negativity, and I allowed it to affect me in a way that I don't usually allow negativity to affect me. What I learned was that my people-pleasing traits came back in full force, and I was like really quite heavily triggered and dragged back to a place of trauma that I was trying to please this person. I was bending over backwards and doing what I can to support them and make them happy. And ultimately, there's nothing that I could do to make them happy because the situation that occurred was something that was out of my control. If you are aware what I'm talking about, that's great. And if you're not, then also don't worry about it. The situation now, as far as I'm concerned, is under control in my mental health, but it did drain my energy and the way that I felt I was able to show up on camera. Probably a more authentic thing to have done would have been to like film the episodes anyway, so that I did need to speak out loud and focus on the positive things that happened. So, back to the positive. A couple of weekends ago, when I was in the shop, unbeknown to me, there was a big pop artist playing in Leeds City Centre at the First Direct Arena. And on a Saturday, which is today, somebody came in and was browsing around, and you could tell from the way they were dressed and the way they carried themselves, they sort of have that inner confidence, which is like a really nice thing to see. Not an arrogance, just like, you know, they carry themselves with like an assuredness, like a certainty that they are maybe exploring, and they're really happy to take their time doing that. I mean, so you can see the walls of this shop. It's not a big space at all. And we're in a small building. I mean, the height of the building is pretty immense, but the actual building itself, not that big. So this guy, you know, male presenting, came into the shop and was having a browse round. He was like, actually didn't have earphones in, and I think that's really rare now, because certainly when I'm out and about, if I'm like focusing on something, I'm in that little do not speak to me, I've got my headphones on, just zone out the world. And also sometimes I'm listening to music for Friday night social and like lots of other things. Anyway, this person was not wearing any earbuds, any headphones, which, as I say, I feel is quite rare. So they came in. When they started chatting to me, they kind of mused out loud, which I really love. So they were, oh, maybe I should get back into roller skating. I remember the last time I did it, it was actually really fun. So I'm like, yes, of course you should get back into roller skating. I don't need another in, right? Just get on with it. You should definitely get back into roller skating. And his accent was one that's not local, but you know, Leeds is a multicultural city, so who am I to judge? So I said, oh, do you live locally? And he's like, no, actually I live in LA now. And I was like, oh, that's really cool. And I kind of leave conversations there, because if I'm in the shop on my own, I'm often quite busy running around doing things. And when I'm here, I've got like the shop jobs to do, but also because it's my business, I've got the business jobs to do. So I kind of have more stuff to do. but I still love learning about other people, their experiences and their lifestyle, and I find people fascinating. Anyway, so I was like, well, I'm ready to leave this conversation here. I don't want to pry. I just want to leave you to browse. And people who visit the city often just browse around the shop and then head on their merry way and do the same in the other shops in the Corn Exchange. They were here for maybe another 5 or so minutes. I say the shop is small, and when you're one person in a shop, it's like weird to spend that amount of time and not speak to anybody else. Like if I'm not on the phone to a customer or something, it's just a bit weird. So I kind of went, oh, that's really cool. Like, so why are you visiting Leeds? Do you mind me asking? And he said, no, not at all. Actually, I'm touring with an artist and we're playing a show tonight. I was like, oh, that's really cool. Do you mind me asking who's the artist? And he was like, oh yeah, it's Jason Derulo. So I'm like, what? Like, hang on a second. Wait, what? So I was like, oh, let's play this cool, Mel. Let's play this cool. So I, oh, okay. I mean, everyone's a human, right? But you know, like there's humans and there's humans. So I'm like, okay, that's awesome. Are you having a great tour so far? And he was like, yeah, yeah, I'm having a cool tour. And I went, what's your role? And he said, oh, I'm like one of Jason's dancers. And I was like, ah, you are a person that I want to talk to. I was like, I'm going to just ask, do you mind if I follow your Instagram? Was that okay? And he was like, yeah, yeah, that's fine. I don't have a signal in here. So he gave me his phone and he was like, put your Instagram in. So I'm like this, roller_girl_gang. Okay, cool. I was like, cool, that's me. I'll find you and I'll follow you back. I was like, this is you, this is the right one. And then I think he bought like a sticker pack. Everybody who visited our shop as a tourist, like came and bought one small thing, our business would be so much healthier in terms of a cash flow. Because no one does it, we all window shop. So he leaves and what do? You go on their Instagram and you find out more about them. So I'm like, oh, wait. He's Jason Derulo's choreographer, not just a dancer. He's the person that created the dances. And yeah. And then I was like, thinking back to the conversation that I actually had with them, which was all a bit, I hope not too ridiculous and gushy, where I'm like, oh my God, you're a dancer. I mean, I'm the world's most awkward dancer because essentially I feel too big for my body and I'm always like, hi. I'm so awkward in this space. I have like wooden limbs and there's no flow. I'm just goofy, like blah, blah, blah. So as I was just goofing about in my dance, one of my lovely customers walked in and was like, I really enjoyed that, Mel, thank you very much. So she got the full awkward dance moment, but from the back. Very excited to like share my philosophy of why we feel awkward in our bodies, and I'm the person who tries to support people with feeling less awkward in their bodies and being okay to take up space when they're skating. And I feel like I actually gave him pause for thought, because I did the whole like, you know, when you take up space on roller skates, when you're learning, you have to like move like this, you're physically taking up more room. And obviously it wasn't until he left and I'm like, ooh, what's your Instagram, that I found out he's Jason Derulo's choreographer. Not just a backing dancer, actually a choreographer. We've had a big order from Vifa, who are one of our like favorite suppliers. Really love that the boot is made in Europe. Let's just get you on. So here we go, here's a Vifa boot. They come in these like little boxes, which is great, except once we've built the boot, it doesn't fit back in the box. Anyway, it's a small problem. So they all come with like white stitching and white laces. They've got a stacked wooden heel. They've got like a lovely smooth, but it's quite narrow, I find. Like the actual sole is
a little bit smaller than maybe, I will say, an American made boot or brand, but that doesn't mean that the actual boot is narrow. It's still a medium width. And then it is like a leather lined boot. It's just really squishy and soft. And you can tell a wifer, because it's got the little like cheek. It's a really cute looking boot. So this ankle padding is just designed to keep the structure of the boot like sturdier for longer, because this part is quite padded. And then also park skaters like it because this cushions your ankle bone, so if you fall over and you bash your ankle, it doesn't hurt as much. So this is a street suede model, and this color is called rose quartz. It's very pretty, not like a very high pink, but it's a nice color. So yeah, we've had a lot of people receive their boots, so I've been spending time doing those builds, which is a very exciting thing. I think I have got not a lot else to share. Thank you very much for joining, and